Welcome to another episode of Team Superheroes. I don't think you need an introduction from me, but we are very happy to have this man back. If you'd mind giving the folks another intro.
For sure. I'm Trent Hazy. I'm a senior product manager on Team's platform ecosystem.
So Trent and I are kind of partners in crime, and we've been talking quite a bit, and we had him on as our first episode, actually, to talk about apps and Teams. You and I were chatting earlier this week, and I said, dude, we've got to film another video on this because you are addressing one of the most common concerns and questions that we get from customers, particularly admins and security departments, which is access that applications have in terms of data and the security and compliance that they're meeting. Is that fair?
100%. It's a big concern and it's a valid one because when you add an application in Teams, there's a developer behind that application and you've got to think about what they have access to.
For sure. So Trent, this is good context. If I'm a developer, I would imagine, though, if I'm building an application for Teams, there are guardrails, so to speak, in place that I have to adhere to by Microsoft policy. Can you talk us through that a little bit?
100%. So the way that the Microsoft Teams API, it's a public API that allows developers to build on top of Teams. The way that it's structured is there's a couple of things we need to outline here. First, you have to define as a developer what permissions you want from your users. So those permissions might be to read a message or to write a message or to send a file. And you have to explicitly call out which permissions you want from users. The second thing you need to define is what type of scope you want to be in. And what I mean by scope is, does your app live in a chat or a channel? Where do I actually interact with that app as a user? And so I'm calling those out because if you have the permissions and the scope, suddenly I know what I'm handing over as a user to a developer. And let's get a little deeper into that in a few minutes.
And this is great context. We know from our interactions with a lot of customers that there are commonly three questions that we get very often. And these are, you know, myths that we want to debunk, so to speak. And the first one is probably the one we get most often, is that an application in Teams, there's a concern that it has access to all of my information. Can you talk us through what these apps actually have access to?
Yeah, that's a great question. So I think it's a valid concern. You know, I add a bot into a team and it's valid to think that it might have access to the entire history of conversations and maybe my chats. So to answer your question, Jace, when a bot or an app is added to a team, it actually only has access to the messages in which it's explicitly mentioned. So if I add a bot in and I say, hey, at Contoso bot, it's only going to see that message where I invoke it. It's not going to see the history because it's not being called out in those interactions. So that's one example of kind of the permission that it's given is only to read messages where it's explicitly mentioned.
So maybe we actually unpack that one a little bit, if you're comfortable with it. You and I are in a channel together in a broader team. We invoke a bot by having a conversation, and let's say there's 20 replies to that conversation. Regardless of what else has happened in the team, the bot only gets access to that conversation and the 20 replies, nothing else in that channel.
Yeah, and actually the bot would have to be mentioned in each of the replies for it to read those as well.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, so it's in order for a bot to read a message, it needs to be called by name.
Now, what about in a chat? If I'm in a chat, only the context in when it was invoked there as well, or would that actually get history?
That's a good question, because a lot of apps actually have their own chat. So let's take, trying to think of my favorite bot. ADP is a cool bot. So I can actually ask it for my most recent pay stub and a few other things. In that chat with the ADP bot, it can actually read everything because it's between me and the HR bot. If I were to have a chat between the two of us and I added another bot in, that is a situation where, again, I would have to explicitly mention it by name for it to read we're typing.
This is great to know. So back to concerns. Concern number two that we hear really often is that if I add an application into Teams, it now has access to all of my personal info.
Yes, valid concern. And actually, if you open the App Store and you click on an app, there's a little pop-up that comes up. And if you scroll down, it'll actually call out the permissions and data that it's going to get access to. In that, it will actually tell you whether it's going to grab your name and your email. So I can show you that in a second, but that's a really helpful tip to know whether you're actually giving the developer your name and your email. Beyond that, if the app wanted your department or your title, it would actually need to configure that through Azure Active Directory, and those are extra permissions. You would know that you'd be giving those up. But at baseline, I suggest you actually look at that pop-up to see, is your name and your email being handed over to the developer?
Now, we also, I would imagine, put guidelines in place for the developers, though, on how they can use that information.
That's correct. Yeah, if you were to feel like you were getting spammed by a developer, that's a violation of the terms of our app store. And so we would actually take that application down. So there, you're totally right. That's not behavior that we would accept.
So let us know if that's happening. Okay, so concern number three. We add an application into Teams, and then we add a file to that application. Take Trello, for example, we use all the time. We have a Trello board, we have a new project card, and we add a file to that card. Now, does the developer have access to that file?
That's a great question. Yeah. This one's pretty intricate, actually. So in order for an application to get access to a file, it has to be given this permission called supports files.
Got it.
So the developer needs to define that when they're making the app. If they do that, you will know it. It's in that same area that I just mentioned, the list of permissions. But more importantly, anytime you share a file with an application, there's an extra little checkpoint that we say, are you sure you want to grant access to this developer? And you confirm. So it's actually really neat to see that we're really careful with your data. The files that you already have shared in OneDrive or anywhere in Teams, no app can access those. It's only when you explicitly state that that app can access a single file that you share it with that developer.
Awesome. Okay, so if I want to get more information about a specific app and the permissions that that application has, if I'm watching this, where do I go?
There's actually three places I want you to look. So the first I mentioned, and that's to actually open the App Store, click on the app, and in that pop-up when you scroll down, you'll see the permissions that that app is requesting from users. So that's number one. The second is we actually have a security and compliance catalog for the third-party apps in our store, and we'll share that link. It's actually an incredible resource to see who the developer is, what data they're requesting, and their overall compliance standards.
And correct me if I'm wrong on that one. That actually came as a request from customers, right?
Exactly.
And us working with them to make sure that we were hitting the right boxes, so to speak, that you can tick off, right?
Yeah, and it builds great transparency and trust in our ecosystem. And then the last is actually a really awesome document from the architect of Teams, Bill Bliss, who wrote up some of these guidelines that explain essentially what these permissions actually are. What can you grant to a bot or a tab or a message extension? And that really helps us understand what these developers can gain access to.
I mean, I say selfishly, and correct me if you feel differently, but that page sparked the conversation you and I are having right now. If there's anything you go check out of those three, I'd go check out that page, right? It's a great resource that's very specific about the capabilities and the guidelines that we put in place on those applications.
100%.
Yeah. Trent, always great having you, man. Thanks so much for the time. Thank you very much for watching, and feel free to leave some comments if you have any questions.